Hi, Caroline, I have some good news. You're gonna be going home later today, so I'm gonna give you some instructions for what to do when you get home. As you know, you had a heart attack 4 days ago, and we treated you here in the hospital in the cath lab with an angioplasty to open up the blood. And then if you're diabetic, 10 milligrams of prednisone, and that should help give you some relief. Caroline during my hospital rotations. She just had her first heart attack and was diagnosed with congestive heart failure. In the hospital, we had a big team take care of Caroline around the clock. And then eventually, we sent her home. From one day to the next, Caroline went from having a team with 50 years of medical schooling taking care of her to then needing to take care of herself with just 30 minutes of training. The system is not cutting it. 1 in 5 patients like Caroline end up back in the emergency room within 30 days, costing the healthcare system $41 billion in readmissions alone. The good news is that 60% of these costs are due to preventable readmissions. I've been working on tackling this problem for the past 5 years. In my PhD, I've been developing portable magnetic resonance sensors to better monitor congestive heart failure patients like Caroline. While collecting data on patients at Mass General, I got to know them on a personal level. I realized that technology was just one part of the solution. We need to bring a guiding human touch to the overwhelming experience of being a chronic patient. That's why we created Pine Health, to make sure that Caroline and the loved ones of everyone in this room will have the support they need after leaving the hospital. With Pine Health, as soon as Caroline is discharged, she gets connected with one of our health coaches. Now, when Caroline leaves the hospital, she doesn't leave her care. Her health coach is always a text away. On the back end, we build software tools that make this personalized health coaching scalable. First, we import doctor's orders into our calendar. The system then automatically sends personalized messages that guide Caroline through her care plan. In the first week, she receives messages about sodium management, as well as on the importance of taking her medications. When Caroline responds, we use machine learning algorithms to predict the best possible responses. The health coach can pick one of the suggested messages or write their own. And through this, we continuously train our platform. Now, we knew that we would need data in order to sell to hospitals. So this summer, we ran 3 trials to start training our system and building our platform. We're engaging over 170 people via text message, including 20 to whom we're offering a high-touch health coaching service. We had a 78% response rate to each of the health tips we sent out. That's 78% of the tips that led to a conversation about stress management or high blood pressure, for example. Each conversation had an average of 8 back-and-forth messages, and at the end of the trial, we had a 90% satisfaction rate. Because of these results, I'm incredibly excited to announce today that MGH wants to pilot our platform later this year. We sell our service directly to hospitals, charging them a per-patient fee. In return, hospitals make money through increased cardiac rehab profits, reduced readmission penalties, and improved quality metrics. Now let me introduce to you the team that actually made all this happen. We've been dedicated our entire lives to improving healthcare. We've invented health sensors that have sold millions of units around the world, and we've spent tens of thousands of hours in the hospital at the patient bedside. Our advisors include some of the top cardiologists in the world, and we could not have done this without their support. Today, healthcare is episodic and reactionary. We're working to make it continuous and preventative. If you're interested in helping us help Caroline and the millions of patients like her stay out of the hospital, come talk to us at our booth. Thank you.